Welcome back from that break. Now, business experts will tell you that what makes an entrepreneur is not the ability to dream and wish, but rather to bring to life the ideas created. Pamela Rain shares that storyline. With just 50,000 shillings at the onset of the COVID-19, she was able to start an interior designing business, and she has made it through. Her success story is highlighted by self-drive, by focus and belief. Here is how to make money.
Yeah, thank you so much, Viola, for having me. My name's Anaebale Pamela Rain, CEO Rain Interiors. It's more so like a home decor, because we've dealt with homes, restaurants, offices, and much more.
Yeah. All right, so were you employed before, and what really inspired you to start something on your own and leave formal employment?
Initially, I worked as a waitress at a certain restaurant in Kampala. I later worked as a cashier, yeah. So by that time, that's when COVID hit, and we had to go home, all of us.
Does that mean that you had a plan all along to be an interior designer, or were you forced to actually think out of the box because you were forced out of employment?
I actually had this mindset of working for someone, being employed. I didn't see this coming. Yeah, since we were all home and I had internet, I decided to learn a few things on YouTube. Yes. The first thing I learned was how to make liquid soap, and I had a friend who taught me. But since there was no, like, my target market was school and hospitals, but I could not sell at that time because schools were closed and we were not allowed to move. Then I later, like, I asked myself, what else can I do? I learned how to make vases. The first money I used, I got 50K, bought a sack of cement, I bought some toothbrushes, I bought paint, and I had some old cloth around. I used it, made the first vase, painted it. I happened to be in town, I got a flower. I don't remember how much it was, but I got one flower, potted it, and posted. A friend of mine in Barra contacted me. She was like, can I have that delivered? Being so new into this, it was so hard for me to deliver in Barra. I told her it won't be possible. Then another person in Mutungo called me, that is so near from here to Mutungo, and I delivered the flower. So after that same money I got, it was approaching my birthday, and I happened to get a friend who gave me 100K. I wanted a cake, and I wanted something to do with my business at that time. So I used that 100K, bought 3 vases, they were small, and went to town, also bought flowers. So I posted on my status. By then I had no business page. I posted on my status and I got like 4 people asking how much. So I sold my first ceramic vase at 50K. Yes. I kept on collecting that money until I would go and shop bigger vases. Yes.
Wow, that's really inspiring. And from the first time you posted online, were you able to then meet the demands of the market? I feel like the feedback was quite, you know, picking up in a short time.
Yeah, I think I had a good eye for good things. Yeah, because I picked I don't know, but my eyes, they were very good. I picked very good verses, and the moment I posted, like, as surprised, like, someone asking me, can I really have that? And yeah, it turned out to be so nice. I sold them out, and I'm like, okay, I need to go and get more. Yes.
So were you buying and reselling, or were you actually making your own, and do you still do the same?
I was buying and reselling, but it involves some kind of arrangement, and I don't know if I can call it art or designing. You buy a separate vase, you then buy a separate flower. You get them together, yes. So I would know this color is going to match this, then this size is going to match this, then I do that.
Okay, so what about your own material? Did you buy material at one point and have to make your own, or did you go ahead with that particular arrangement?
I kept on doing the other vases of cement and cloth, but the issue was they were irritating my hands. And then see how I have this idea of getting, like buying those vases and reselling them, where I don't have to get issues. It was, yes, this other like type of the vases I started with were still there, but I had to add in this. I did it for some quite time. Then because of that issue of irritation and what, I stopped it. Yes, I actually told myself, let me just do this on order. Yes, when Viola orders, it's when I'm going to do it. Not doing and keeping them.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so why did you choose interior designing over all other business, especially being in lockdown and all that?
When I was a kid, I remember I used to plant flowers like anyhow at home, and I would have fights with my grandmother. I would like bring a flower and put it immediately after the doorstep. Yeah, I think then I was young, I didn't know where to put flowers or what to do exactly. But instead of correcting me, she would be, no, don't put that there. And she would take them away. But I mean, right now we have them and it's fine. She loves them. So I think it's something I had from childhood and passion. Yes, I love good things. I love beautifying spaces. Yeah, that's why I chose this kind of job that I'm doing.
And for most people, passion does not always translate into money. They do not believe enough that passion can actually make money. Yeah. And the economy at times shows you the answer that passion will not pay you. So how sure were you that you were going to make money from this?
The things I believe in, one is commitment, self-driven, and passion. Yes, I loved this thing. I'm telling you, I started with 50K. And I'm like, I'm going to make these vases. I'm going to make it. Yes. But time came. I had to keep the money to make it grow big.
So I see that you're majorly working at home. That's where I found you and some of your stock. So how has working from home since back then helped you to be able to, I guess, maybe save or even sell more?
Yeah, the first thing I'm earning, yes. I've given other people employment. Like right now I do furniture, but I contract with the carpenter. Me, I have my ideas. I spend most of the time on Pinterest and YouTube. I will go get an idea, take it to the carpenter, then he does the work. Yes, at least I'm helping someone to earn a living.
Okay.
Yeah.
And take us through those operational costs. A saving by working from home, but then having to hire someone else to do part of the work. How does all that unfold?
I think it starts with how you portray yourself.
Okay.
And how good you are in terms of communication. Mm-hmm. And the trust as well. Yeah, because at this moment I know even when I don't have money, I'll go to people that I've been working with. They give me things on a date.
Yes.
Then I pay later. Yes.
And you get majorly your clients from online. How is that coming along?
When I started growing big, I got a business page on Facebook that is at Rain Interiors. So what I did, I joined most of the business groups that are on Facebook. I make a post, actually make two posts in a week. Yes, I make two posts in a week and share in more than 100 groups. In those 100 groups, I find, I actually get like 10 people asking how much. Then in those 10 people, I will get like 6 wanting to know where I work from. Then I tell them how my business operates. Then I get like 4 who will buy. So when I go into someone's home, I would love to leave everything beautified.
Yes. Yeah. So I think really what drives your business and what's making you excel is passion.
Yeah. I love what I'm doing.
All right.
So
that's very wonderful.
Yeah.
I'm taking home with me the fact that you can actually make passion your way of life and just have fun and yeah. make money. So I'm glad that you're happy.
When you're doing what you love, you enjoy it. It's easier. Even when challenges come, mm-hmm. you find a way of overcoming them. Mm. Yes.
All right. It's been lovely, Pamela, having you on
Thank
this
you so
set.
Much.
All right. Indeed, from Pamela's story, you see that you can start against all odds, but make sure that you have a unique way of doing business. This will make you stand against so many and also earn you more and loyal customers. Now, it is often said that little children are better at learning things and mastering them. So this week in Personal Finance, Flavia Nabukwasi, a financial expert, shares how learning to save like little children could actually take you through your journey to learning how to save big.
My name is Nabukwasi Flavia. I work with Be Money Wiser.
All right, Flavia. So your topic is save like little children so as to save more consistently. Just run us through what that means.
Okay, saving like little children so as to save more consistently, meaning that saving, we should take saving as a culture. Yes, apparently we've realized that saving like little children can really help adults in saving consistently. When now we look at saving like little children, we realize that kids save consistently. Every little penny that you give them, they save it. They will not want to go buy a sweet or something without saving that money. So first and foremost, they have a parent has to buy for them a piggy bank. When they have the piggy bank or a saving box, they are able to save that little money that the parent gives them. So if a child can sacrifice to keep money in a piggy bank, what about you as an adult? That means you can also sacrifice and save. A child may be saving for a particular goal, maybe buying a toy or buying something that they desire. So as an adult, you can also save. You can also adopt from what the kids are doing. They are sacrificing. Sacrifice, save. Saving is actually sacrificing the little that you have. In whatever amount of money that you get some percentage, like 10% of your money that you've earned, and save it in the box. So that at the end of the day, you know, actually, you get to know that saving will help you in future. Like basically you'll get what you really need. When the money grows and you feel that you've really filled your saving box, what we advise people is, as you save, keep writing, keep your records, write somewhere and know how much is in the piggy bank and how much is on the paper. Does it tally? If it tallies, what were you saving this money for? What was your goal? And for how long did you want to save that money? So at the end of the day, if there's something lacking in the house and maybe you've saved more than what you really expected, you can pick some of what you saved and use it for the emergency that has come up. And then after the balance, use it for your goal that you saved for. When kids start saving at a younger age, you realize that they will have this financial independence with them. Parents who have literally encouraged their kids saving or taught them how to save in the saving box, you realize that these kids grow up knowing that, no, I have to save. If I want something, let me work for it, save, and then get what I really saved for.
Now, the units closed Wednesday's trading session at 3,760 and 3,770 levels, weaker from the day's opening of 3,720 and 3,730 per dollar. This was attributed to interbank demand. Here now is a full report for the Forex and money markets. That's it for this week's edition of The Business Show. Thank you very much for watching. Remember that we now have a business segment in the morning show every Tuesdays. So remember to watch as experts give you tips on how to rescue your business from this very difficult economy. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good night.